I think down at the end. Smash team. They've been around since Smash 4. Talon plays the melee, so two very experienced players. Just kind of jumping into this, haven't been watching much of before. I see these guys playing the late percent game, just really trying to get those draw hits. Yeah, that's gonna take that. I saw him going with a lot of those capes in a different set, and I didn't see it playing out too well this time. While I wasn't getting punished in that set, then definitely took full advantage and just established that stock lead. So I don't know. One of my big hands on Talon's play is why I think. Oh my. What's this? Missed input? Okay, missed input, I guess. But Ren had spectacular coverage of that. Most people, you know, they've seen missed input and kind of like freak out themselves. Okay, Ren is just does not want me to talk at all. He's quickly working on a three stop that, you know, just maybe a minute ago looked pretty even. So Talon finally being able to scrape off that first guy. That was really what he needed. You know, even a glimmer of hope. Or, not losing the entire momentum in the blue stop. Okay, so Ren just kind of helicopters out of there. He still doesn't really have much sign of slowing down. He's just kind of swinging at Talon and getting punished minorly. But Talon's chip damage is nothing compared to the donkey damage. Oh my god. Okay, so Talon actually mounting this comeback a little bit. He just doesn't want to get to, you know, like a smash kill percent or okay, just like that. So he puts it back in the even spell count. And this is totally understandable. It's the first game, both players. No, come on, air dodge. That's unfortunate, Talon. I think if he had an air dodge, he definitely would have been able to make it. But yeah, that was a very silencing set, both to me and to Talon. Game. I just feel like Ren kind of ran away with that, like the entire time. Hey, Grant. I was just watching, like, honestly, I was trying to commentate, and every time I would say something, Ren would just, like, absolutely eviscerate when Talon sucks.
I want to see what Talon comes up with. Was this day Mario? Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I like the squad trick I was varying into, like, all the different games and sets he was playing, but I definitely like the solid, static Mario.
To be honest, like, he has a ZSS. And like my stupid brain just says it's always easy as us against him. And I know he has one.
Yeah.
So I'd like to see him like dig deep.
No, I definitely know you're right, but I mean Talon can do this. Like,
he totally can.
He has a positive win ratio on Ren from my incorrect.
I don't think that's the case, but
yeah,
I don't
wrong.
Know exactly what their set count is. I know that historically Talon has struggled with Ren historically. I don't know like what the count is, but I just think it's like a heavy thing with Talon, you know, and Ren, you know, he's always usually take either DK or Ganon against Ren. I know Talon has at least, you know, one hit on him, but I remember watching this win.
Yeah.
I think definitely next phase.
But that's, we'll see right now. So this is very similar to what was happening in game one. It was like, it just seemed like they were distracting percent, neither of them going for big, So game one was kind of marked by neither of them buying the break in the beginning, neither of them want to break the ice with any big neutral starts, but Ren just kind of, I think, has come out of his shell.
Yeah, I think Ren's really confident against Mario, you know?
Yeah, I'm really liking just the, how he's really kind of just
nice
shooting.
Not able to get the cape out, though.
Breakdancing on him with a down smash. And so already just making this 2-2 shots is way better than last time. So we're already seeing fast improvement from Callum.
There's a low percent combo.
Nice percent combo.
See how far he can take it. See, the second up there would have
almost whips that punish.
But he got it.
Okay, so no last hit of down air. Callum just wrapping this up. This is what Mario wants.
Yeah, this is important. It's also, it's really important too to, like, you know, push this all the way.
Yeah.
Because DK can make up the difference pretty quickly. And there it is.
Yeah, you can just fall apart so easily if you stop affecting your opponent.
Ren really trying to go aggro with those back airs, and Callum just able to wait it out and punish it with the strongest possible
punch.
So
Callum having his biggest lead he's had all set. I think the only lead, really. Or anyway, so I want to see how far he's going to take this. Yeah, just that little.
I like that little
short hop aerial slash tilt combos are really fantastic.
Callum's keeping it really simple but really effective.
Right. So Ren really good with these back airs, just kind of just sliding.
Had the full shield, luckily, so he's not going to suffer.
Countless so much confidence in the shield because it paid off.
Yeah. So if you, I mean, if you know you have a full shield, you can pretty much do anything.
Yeah. I don't like the forward air. Maybe an update with less than percent. I don't think Ren's inexperienced enough to get hit by that.
Oh, and there it is. Yeah, Mario just not going to have, like, the big hitbox up in front of them.
Both games are just seeing each other. We've seen both these players just calling each other.
Classic, and that's going to even it up for,
yeah, so,
for Callum.
I don't know. I don't know much to say that these players aren't saying themselves. I mean, I was kind of saying in the beginning, just kind of remarking on it. Yeah, Kemal's getting thrown around, but I knew we had the capability to bring it back, and maybe Callum at the beginning of the game would have done that, but these are two very experienced players, and Callum shows that.
I was really impressed just the way Callum, really, after a tough game one, totally kept his composure, because he was on foot on his punches, he didn't panic, he never got nervous against DK. DK is a really good character at kind of scaring you, because you don't want to lose to DK, but at the same time, you have to respect him. Ren's DK has scared the living shit out of me many a time.
I see, I'm gonna go play Warren in the set right now.
Yep. Okay, man, good luck.
Thank you.
All right, who's ready for the Hydro Guy solo cast? I don't know how to do this, but let me give it a shot. Oh wow, okay, so you missed an important development, which you will now be made aware of. We have the Renter.
Like, it takes a certain kind of player to make me respect, I think, switching after a loss. I'm just going from, you know, just trying to shoot DK to Richter. I don't really like that same girl's confidence. Callum with the momentum to just take this and just exploit.
This is a matchup I don't know if I've seen before. I imagine Callum just being a smart player will have a pretty good edge guard on Richter, so really gonna be really important for Ren here to keep stage control.
Yeah, it's just for me with Callum, Mario just seems like a good character. He's just like, once he gets in on Drummond, he's gonna just throw him around for a while. And I think he gets the deck also, which Callum is not one.
And that's kind of the opposite is true, though. I mean, Richter with stage control is as scary as it gets. I mean, he can just really rack it up. Really good use of cave there. Callum has such a good awareness.
Callum is solid water. Again, like, these players definitely exploit. They don't want to put themselves in any risky situations, but they're definitely content with wrecking at the time. That's a big hit.
Yeah, no cave there from Callum.
That's another
no
big
cave
hit.
There,
okay,
yep.
So this is Ren's starting to inch back into his corner.
Yeah, we're pretty
Callum
even
just
here.
Seems to, like, every time he gets him off stage.
Good cave, but not gonna catch up to you there.
He's gonna get him off stage. I don't know. I kind of want to see Callum.
Alright, now it's happening.
Wait, no, ask Warren if he... Warren still needs time. I'm waiting for Warren. Once if he needs to wait.
Okay, so...
Okay, so Callum... I kind of stopped watching last 2 seconds. But Callum's just holding this. Like, I'm about to expect. I'm just not a fan of just losing to instant counterpick. Like...
I think, to be honest though, what it is with Ren is he enjoys this character and wants to get better with the character, so I respect giving him, like, that high-pressure breath experience to say, like, you know, I wanna see what this character is made of. Like, I wanna see if I can, you know, switch it up and still have success.
I totally understand that mentality, but I feel like it just the attitude just seems like a almost a desperate kind of thing. Like, DK was not that. He thought DK wasn't supposed to be.
I don't think that was advisable.
I think it would have been one thing if he started the set with one of the Belmonts, but I feel like just going to the yeah, I mean, like, I don't know what's going on in Red's head. You got a very good.
I'll tell you what's going on in Red's head. He's just fucking like Tokyo. That's my take.
Thank you, Grant.
Grant psychology. Okay, after all this drama.
Alright, Callan.
Alright, so a little bit of an SD from Rand. Let's see if he can bring it back. I definitely saw Rand bring it back really well. He was in deficits against Wesley last week, against Soyokan. So now, no jump on this Mario. He's going to make it back just barely. So ooh, air dodge is out of the down air. So that came in bad for Red, but he escapes. And he has to be back on the ground. See how he gets his stock off. Oh wow. He's facing out that S smash, just gonna get a weak hit. With this one with the shield, but there it is, the taper S smash. Gonna be way too strong to even use there, but yeah, it's a go. Now I'm looking to eliminate that S smash. Dragon needs to hit. Now I'm gonna play this super safe. Right now, but he still got super sensitive. Risky up B. He's gonna get a grab for a punish. Yell up smash coming up in power. How's Ren gonna get off the ledge? How is Ren gonna usually get up good stats stocks? Really good up tilt. Getting himself back on the ground. That's not. This is so scary! Such good awareness of these different projectiles that Rikyu has. Up tilt, the holy water! Oh, no conversion! No conversion, that could have been it! So this is best of five, so that was a scary situation, but not as scary as I thought it was. Callan taking the 2-1 lead. We'll see if the Richter stays out here. It looked really good there at the end, but really the SD cost him more than anything. I don't see Ren play this character a lot against Stormover, but I mean, he has this character in his DNA. He didn't win that at any time and probably do a good job. One, go! I think Callan also likes Callan's fire. He's content to just throw a fireball. So tired. I mean, if you just threw a frame off, he's gonna be cool.
Oh, shit. I've never done that in my life.
Tornado gonna stab long enough to hit him.
Are
you? Ooh. Red not happy about that tornado missing. Four or five. Oh,
into the F smash, but Talon's far into his trap. We just really like range back to him. We just need kill percent. Talon just keeping stage control really well, man. He just keeps pushing him back off, backing up damage. Oh, not that jump there. Oh, this is like, what do you think to do that option? Kate will finish it.
Why do I play meta? Oh my fucking god.
Did you see that?
It's a toxic relationship, man.
Well, maybe not so.
I can deal with fucking tornado not working. But, jump.
Yeah, that shuttle loop was weird, man. I don't know.
How did your shuttle loop fucking drew much?
That's what I meant, my bad. Decided. Richter, though?
Richter, though, man.
Do I play this character? You're right. You're right.
I believe it's